SchoolFreeware's Word 2007 Tutorials. Tutorial 19. Making a more advanced poster. This tutorial will show you how to create a more advanced poster, and I'll set the page layout size to tabloid. Now you don't always have to use tabloid, which is 11 by 17. You can use tabloid extra if your print shop or your printer supports it. Very simple to modify. I'll go to more paper size, and here you can set the paper size width to, I believe tabloid extra is 12 and the height is 18 inches. I'll click on OK and I'll just ignore this, and now the paper is set for tabloid extra. I'm just going to set this back to tabloid because the print shop only supports tabloid size, so I'll click on 11 by 17. I'll go ahead and set the margins to custom margin. I'll make the top 0, the left 0, the bottom 0, and the right 0. I'll click on OK, and I'll just ignore. I'll click on view, and I'll go to grid lines, so now I have a nice grid. The grid lines will not be printed out, but they're just here to help me center and adjust everything so it looks very nice. First thing I'm going to do is go to insert, and I'll insert the heading word art for the document. Click on word art and then select the word art I want. Room 105 we'll put. I'll click on OK and very quickly adjust the size. I'll set it to in front of text and center and drag down. I'll click off the word art. So that way I can insert different objects without messing up the word art. I'll go ahead and insert the pictures, so I'll click on insert picture. I'll select the picture of one of the girls. I'll select the text wrapping to in front of text, and now I can move it over. I'll just pop it right here. Click off the picture and insert the other one. Insert picture. And I'll go ahead and insert. Set the text wrapping to in front of text and move it down. Let's line it up real quick. And that looks pretty good. Alright, time for the text boxes. Insert. Text box. I'll select the simple text box. Set the text wrapping to in front of text and I'll move it down. Okay, that looks about right. I'll bring it over more towards the center. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to click on the borders so the text box is active. And I'll just go to copy, click off the text box, go to paste, and now I can move the second text box over. I'm going to make a few adjustments here. Okay, that looks about right. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to highlight the text in the second text box and delete the text. I'll also delete the text in the first text box. And finally, I'll go over to Format, Create Link, and with the first text box already selected, I'll just click on the second text box, and now the two are linked together. To save some time, what I'll just do is I'll go over here and select all the text within this text box and just copy and paste. So I'll just copy. And I'm just going to paste special by going to Home, and I'll just go paste special and select unformatted text, click on OK, and that way I can show you the formatting of the text that we're going to use. So I'll just highlight the text that I've inserted. I believe it was size 72, bold. The color is going to be dark red. I'll go to shape fill and select yellow. Okay, we're just a little bit off here, so I'll just click on both text boxes by shift click, so that way they're both highlighted. And I'll just move this down a little bit, so hopefully we can do some quick fine tuning. I'll just use the arrow keys to move these text boxes and pictures around. Shift click and arrow keys to move up. I'll just highlight all of them and I'll go to line spacing and select 1 point instead of 1.5. And now I can adjust the text boxes so I have a little bit more space to add the buses at the very bottom. Okay, I'll click off the text boxes. I'll go on to Insert, Clip Art. I'll search for a bus. And find the one that I want. I'll just click on the bus. Here it is. Set the text wrapping to in front of text. And now I'll just drag it down into the poster. I'm just going to resize a little bit. That looks good. Move it over. And I'll go ahead and copy and paste. So I click on copy, click off of the bus, click on paste, and there's the second one there. I'll just move the second bus over. And when it's highlighted, I'll go into Format and I'll select Flip Horizontal, so that way both buses are facing each other. Okay, I'm going to take these grid lines off, so I'll just go to View and take the grid lines off. And here we have a nice poster, but I like to change the background. The background is currently white, and I like to put a little color into it, so I'll go to Page Layout, and I'll select Page Color. And I'll go ahead and use one of the recent colors. Now here is the situation with using Page Color. If I were to go ahead and try to print this out, I'll click on Office button here. I'll go to Print and Print Preview. And you'll see that the color is not in the Print Preview. And here's why. I'll get rid of the Print Preview and go to Word Options. And under Display, we have Print Background Colors and Images. Now if this box is checked, click on OK, and go to Print Preview to see how it'll print out. Now we see that the color is in the background. I close Print Preview. To further complicate this matter, if I were to save as a PDF, this background color will be in the PDF regardless of how that checkbox is checked.